We want to simplify each expression using only positive exponents. We first have 3x to the fourth times 4x to the third. And since 3x to the fourth means 3 times x to the fourth, and 4x to the third means 4 times x to the third, if it helps us, we can change the order of this multiplication. We can write this as 3 times 4 times x to the fourth times x to the third. In this form, notice that 3 times 4 is equal to 12, and then x to the fourth times x to the third would be x to the power of 4 plus 3. When multiplying the bases are the same, we add the exponents, so this simplifies to 12 x to the seventh. If you're wondering why we're adding the exponents here, if we expand this, it'll help explain why. X to the fourth is equal to 4 factors of x. X to the third is equal to 3 factors of x. Notice how we have a total of 7 factors of x, which is why we add the exponents, and this is equal to x to the seventh. Next we have 5x to the fourth raised to the third power. To simplify this, it's probably helpful to think of this as 5 to the first power times x to the fourth raised to the third power. Remember, if the base does not have an exponent, the exponent would be 1. So here we have powers raised to powers, so we multiply the exponents. So this would be equal to 5 to the power of 1 times 3, that's 3, times x to the power of 4 times 3, that's 12. But we can simplify 5 to the third, that's equal to 5 times 5 times 5, which is 125. So this would be 125 x to the 12th. But if you weren't sure how to start this type of problem, as long as we know an exponent tells us how many factors of the base we have, we could expand this and still simplify. For example, 5x to the fourth raised to the third means we have 3 factors of 5x to the fourth. So if we expand this, notice how we can see the 5 times 5 times 5, which is equal to 125, and then we'd have x to the power of 4 plus 4 plus 4, which would be 12. Notice the result is the same. Next we have 18x to the sixth divided by 6x to the fourth. Let's first simplify the coefficients, and then we'll simplify x to the sixth divided by x to the fourth. We'll notice that 18 divided by 6 is equal to 3, and then x to the sixth divided by x to the fourth would be x to the power of 6 minus 4, so this simplifies nicely to 3x to the second. But again, if we weren't sure how to approach this problem, we could also write the numerator and denominator in prime factored form and then simplify. For example, 18 would be equal to 2 times 9, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3, so we could write 18x to the sixth as 2 times 3 times 3, that's the prime factorization of 18, times 6 factors of x, divided by the prime factorization of 6 would be 2 times 3, and then we have 4 factors of x. Simplifying this fraction, notice how here we have 2 over 2 and 3 over 3 that simplifies to 1. There's also 4 factors of x in common that would simplify to 1. This simplifies to 1, so does this, and so does this. Notice how we're left with 3x squared. This also explains why we're subtracting the exponents when dividing. Notice how there were 4 factors of x in common, which is why we subtracted 4 to determine the exponent for x. Now for the last example, our simplified expression should not contain negative exponents. So right now this would be 5 to the first power times x to the power of negative 2. To change the sign of the exponent, we can write this in fraction form by putting this over 1. If we move a base across a fraction bar, it changes the sign of the exponent given by this rule here. You can think of this as 1 divided by a to the negative m equals a to the m over 1. So if we take x to the power of negative 2, move it to the denominator, or across the fraction bar, it changes the sign of the exponent. Notice how the 5 has an exponent of positive 1, so we leave the 5 in the numerator. So this simplifies to 5 divided by x to the power of positive. I hope you found this helpful.